Hey guys, it's me, Jay Stone, and today we're going to focus on creating virtual backgrounds in Zoom. So if you are not familiar with Zoom, I give a detailed explanation with this in a previous video, so check for the link below. But right now, I'm just going to talk to you about virtual backgrounds. Now, with everyone doing a lot of self-distancing and working from home, there is a need to do video conferencing. And of course, my favorite platform for that is Zoom. But one of the things that also happens is people have, when they join the virtual meeting, there's a lot of clothes and junk and boxes in the background, and people don't want folks to see their dirty house or junky or just the kids in the background, you know, cutting the fool. So how do you create a virtual background? So the first thing I want to do is let's just talk about creating the background, and then we can go right into Zoom. So I'm going to start here in Canva, because when I opened my Canva last weekend, I saw Zoom virtual backgrounds. So now when I go in here, I don't see it right away. Zoom has these categories, right? And so if you don't see it right away, just start to type in Zoom and look what comes up. Suggested Zoom virtual backgrounds. It tells you the dimensions, everything. So I went ahead and created the Zoom virtual backgrounds, and they have the video. This is like clouds. They have that stuff moving. They have all of these virtual backgrounds that are just kind of like picturesque. So I'm going to pick something that might look like, I'm just going to choose this boardroom, right? Now, mind you, it has no branding or anything like that on it. I personally want to have my logo in the background, so I'm just going to browse my folders, and I'm using Canva Pro, which does have folders. You guys will know that a lot of the, if you're using the free version of Canva, it's not going to have that. Okay, so I'm going to take my favicon and drop it in here in the corner so it won't be too distracting. Drop it right up here in the corner. Okay, and then I'm going to rename this I'm going to reabbreviate this BB boardroom. Okay, and then I'm just going to download that. I'm going to leave it as a PNG file, click the download, and then determine where I'm going to save it and drop it in my folder. So I'm going to just create a Zoom folder here. That way I can know where it is, and there we go. Okay, so it's pretty cool with that. Then what you want to do is open Zoom, and you can go to settings, right? And when you go to settings, and settings is that little gear, let me do that again, right here under your picture, you would have needed to have downloaded the Zoom app. So this is in the Zoom app. You click that little picture, and it has all your settings, and you want to go down to virtual background. And as you guys can see, here's the virtual backgrounds. And so you see my picture video. Don't judge me by my hair, right? Don't judge my hair today. So you can see it says none if I choose something that I've already created, which is this one. And the one thing about it is it does not always do like hair properly. You see my hands missing. So it doesn't do well for me. So the key here is light. A lot of people will put a green screen in the background so that there's more of a distinction between your background and your body. And so some people will do a green screen. So that's kind of how you put the background up there. Now, initially, you're going to have mirror my video. It's probably going to be checked, and you see it put my logo and everything backwards, right? So I'm going to uncheck that. Now, if I want to add the background that I just created, I'm going to click add image. All right, and I'm going to go down to where I put the new one, which is here. I'm just going to select it and upload it. There it is. It popped in right there and it's selected. So this is the one that I just created in Canva. So it's really pretty cool if you have everything that you need. Now, if you click, I have a green screen, it did even worse, right? So the green screen is saying, I want to be able to tell. So it doesn't, when there's not a distinction between you and your background. So my background is gray, my hair is gray. So it can't see a really strong distinction. So it doesn't really work for me. However, I see lots of people and it works for lots of people. So let's look at one additional option that I think is pretty cool for it. Bear, if you're not familiar with Bear. Bear is the company, the paint home decor company. Okay. And Bear put out a group of backgrounds. And so I'll drop this link also in the video. But here's a link where they actually created virtual backgrounds. And so there's a letter from Bear. Then they have instructions on a PDF on terms of how to use it for Zoom. And this is right in a Google Drive, and they tell you how to download it from here, put your background. So it kind of walks you through the instructions on how you can use their backgrounds. All right. And then here are the backgrounds, what are super cool and super nice. Here's one, here's the other. And then you can actually save these and then drag them into Canva and put your logo on it if you would like. So these are beautiful Bear backgrounds. So this is a way that you can do it. Hope this is helpful for you with creating your virtual experience. I'm Jai Stone. You can find more videos like this on my YouTube channel. Also follow me on jaistone.com. That's jaistone.com.